with my babies on a runaway train, on a runaway train, on a runaway train. It's a one-way ride. Time's running out. I'm screaming faster and non-stop joy. I know no way back. Tell my mama I'm coming back home as soon as this train runs off its track. Me and my baby's on a runaway train. Me and my baby's on a runaway train. On a runaway train. On a runaway train.
You can't lie to your race, but you can't lie to nobody with that ghost in your face. And the same God you're so afraid is gonna send you to hell. It's the same one you're gonna answer to. It's a shame. Well, your sister's blaming everybody, and I don't blame her, man, I guess I do the same. If you were my brother, man, I'd probably stand by you. But you ain't, man, so gotta go my way. And I ain't gonna crawl up on no horse, 'cause I got thrown off of one when I was young, and I ain't no cowboy, so I ain't going where I don't belong. Wouldn't do you no good, but you know that a damn near killed me too. So I ain't gonna mourn for you, man, now that you're gone. Me and you, we liked our pills and our whiskey, but you don't want your head full of either one when the house gets quiet and dark. Feeling good, it used to come so damn easy. Racing trains from 2nd Street to Avalon, take a trip down memory lane. You don't see no friendly faces. All the houses have been painted, and nobody knows your name. Guess it's enough to make a man not wanna be nobody's daddy. If all he thinks he's got left to hand down his guilt and shame.
Teeth marks in your own damn hands, thrown out before the day's expired.
too hard, just couldn't kill you. So in the end, you had to do it. You had to do it. Do it yourself. You had to do it. You had to do it. You had to do it. So do it yourself. Do it yourself.
If I make it through this year, I think I'm gonna put this bottle down. This is time goes on, I'll grow to miss it less than I want now. And I think I'm gonna tell her that I'm gonna go away for a while. Till I can get this demon out. Always humming in my head, and it's all I hear. Could you read my lips if I pulled you near enough? Could you read my fortune in the bottom of this coffee cup? Can you tell me how to tell what I've had? Thank you. It's hard to be.
Together after not really seeing each other for 18 months, and we had a show coming up, a few shows coming up, and of course now we're getting to go out and tour, and like, God, we hadn't seen each other in so long, do we need to like practice? Nah. Instead we booked just a few days of studio time and thought, well,
we'll needing go to practice was a pretty good excuse to get out of the house a few days earlier. We're not above it.
But we thought, well, instead of, we'll just practice in the studio and, you know, demo a few songs, see what's happening. And we ended up making a record. So we got a new record. It's going to probably be like end of summer before it comes out, because I don't know anyone that pays attention to the world of vinyl. The record plants are all backed up to hell and back right now because people have discovered that records are cool, and so now you've got Walmart ordering like 1.5 million units of Fleetwood Mac's Rumors and Hotel California, and it's clogging up all the works, and so indie bands can't get their fucking records made, and we're somewhere in that mid-range between kind of indie with major label distribution or something, but it's still, it'll probably be the end of summer before we have our fucking record. But Barbie's mixing it as we speak, like tonight, is working on mixing it. She's been sending me mixes all day, which I haven't had time to listen to, and we're mastering it in a couple weeks, so it's like in the can, and I'm gonna do a song off of it, and the one we actually know how to play.
Yeah, there's that.
There is that.
There's that learning curve.
You record it, but that don't mean you know it. You made it happen, you got it on tape, and then you have to actually learn how to play it. But we actually kind of know this one. But so it's based on it's a true story, basically. Well, yeah, it's a true fucking story. So we grew up in the Shoals area, Muscle Shoals area, North Alabama, and back when we grew up there, it was a hellhole kind of. It was a dry county, and Bible Belt is all shit. And if it was actually kind of awesome in that regard, because I loved to drink when I was a teenager and was underage. And at like 16, I looked about 12 or 13, but the bootleggers didn't give a shit. And you know, people are gonna drink, so you know, if it's a dry county, you have bootleggers. Or you go up to the state line, which in our case happened to be the Tennessee state line, about 15 miles up a windy, scary two-lane road. And up there you had package stores, beer only, and you had a few like honky-tonks. And I mean like really in the most literal sense, like picture the bar from the Blues Brothers movie, basically, except they didn't bother with chicken wire, because it's like, fuck it, if they don't like you, let them hit you with a bottle. So and you had B's Place, and you had Bobby's Place, and you had Johnny's Place, and then just past all of them was like the slightly nicer club, and that was Club 13, with Roman numerals, because they were classy. And you had to be a member. It was a dollar. And by the time we met and started playing together, they voted liquor in. And so I'm thinking, oh man, our hometown's gonna get cool now. It's gonna be like Athens, Georgia. There's gonna be like cool clubs and cool bands, and we're gonna be part of it.
In about 40 years.
Literally. Instead, no, all the honky-tonks at the line just closed and reopened in Carver County. And so it was the same old shit. But the nicest one of those was Club 13. And they still had the Roman numerals, because they were still classy. And guy that owned it, he was okay guy. And he didn't necessarily like our band, but he didn't hate our band as much as most people did there. But we could only pull about 15 people on a Wednesday night. So basically, he would throw a bone at us about a couple times a year and let us open for some like hair metal band that was touring, come through town. So we opened for Sidewinder.
We did.
And anyway, I wrote this song about it. This song's called Welcome To, with the number 2, like Prince, because it was the 8th. Club 13 with the Roman numerals, because it's classic.
Traffic. It's about enough to
see how your week is gone, Terry. And make love till dawn. But your mama, she'll be calling. What I brought that bottle home for. And we'll all get to fight the way we always do. Saturday morning I'll be singing these blues. Last night I slept with my boots on again. One cut on my forehead, one on my chin, on the hall. Most folks don't really
no love like this.
Standing in the hallway, red plastic.
cup and one of them big long cigarettes. You asked me if I could play you some Dylan. I said, Dylan, who? You told me to kiss your ass. I apologize, but you could tell I didn't mean by the way I rolled my eyes. Then you said, what do you mean it was you? Somehow I knew you were gonna tell me why.
Started forming 5 o'clock p.m. Funnel clouds touched down 5 miles north of Russellville. Sirens were blowing, clouds spat rain. And as the thing came through, I swear it sounded like a train. Thank you. watched the rain. It sucked him out the window. He ain't come home again. All she can remember is that it sounded like a train. Truck stop, litter up the highway, I've been told. And I heard that missing truck ended up in Kansas. Maybe it was ours.
Set me free, but it's the same one that I see.
He ripped up off the ground and wrapped around me. Don't let it fool you, this highway's pain.
Just putting me out of my misery.
roommate's gun. After I was my roommate's gun. After I was my roommate's gun. It's my roommate.
See y'all soon.